Samuel Orphanage, located in Gading Serpong, South Tangerang, Banten. There's a total of 41 people living inside this orphanage, which consists of 39 orphans and 8 sitters. It's been here since the year 2000, and as you can see, the condition of the building isn't very appealing anymore. Why don't we take a look inside?
Berbagai latar belakang, dari rumah sakit, diantar oleh orang lain, macam-macam gitu ya, dari klinik-klinik bersalin. Jadi anak-anak yang bermasalah, ini semua anak-anak yang bermasalah, jadi dibuanglah oleh orang tuanya. Jadi bapak menampung anak-anak itu dibuang.
Bagaimana perasaan bapak ketika panti asuhan ini dalam proses dibangun?
Bapak senang sekali, karena apa yang menjadi kerinduan Tuhan dalam hidup Bapak sekeluarga untuk mendirikan sebuah panti. Panti ini visinya satu kerajaan surga. Kemudian anak-anak yang ada di panti asuhan ini itu berawal dari bayi. Bayi-bayi yang hamil di luar nikah. Jadi itu terjadi sejak hampir 13 tahun yang lalu. Ketika,
Esther suka nggak tinggal di sini?
Suka.
Perasaannya gimana?
Senang.
Senang atau sedih?
Senang.
Seseorang dari luar mengadopsi Esther, Esther mau nggak?
Enggak.
Enggak, kenapa?
Nggak tahu.
Apa udah terlalu biasa di sini?
So now we know about how these children feel. Or do we? Ms. Deborah Towner, psychiatric social worker and school counselor, might be able to tell us more.
They weren't truly orphans. They still had family, they just didn't have anyone to take care of them. And what I found is in different parts of the world, orphanages are sometimes used kind of like a boarding school, or they're used for kids just because there's no one to take care of them.
Some children like knows that they are adopted, if they are adopted eventually.
But do you know that there was old-fashioned ideas about that, and different countries believe different things? Some families thought we should keep that a secret. We should not tell children they were adopted. We'll just pretend that they were born to our family and always were. And so they kept it a secret. But one of the things that happened is sometimes kids found out when they got a little bit older because somebody knew, and then the child felt like their parents had been lying to them forever.
Now that we received some opinions from the experts, what about the non-experts? Let's see what this WA community has to say about this issue. Have you two ever visited an orphanage before?
Yes.
No.
Really?
I've been to one once.
Probably when I was 17, I visited an AIDS orphanage in Thailand.
How did you feel when you visited the orphanage?
Depressing.
I see.
It was pretty sad to see little kids that were orphans, but we went there to give some donations.
They were receiving adequate care, but it was still sad to think that they would have a life that was defined by this disease.
What do you think you would feel if you were one of the orphans?
That's a great question. I don't know, because I think that as children, it's always difficult, and you know, you struggle with your parents.
Well, it really depends on the condition of the orphanage.
Yeah.
If the orphanage was worse than the last home, then obviously you'd feel a bit sad. But, you know, if you were being taken away from conditions that were worse, then, you know, you'd feel relieved.
Yeah.
So, how long do you think it would take to adopt a child from the orphanage?
You want to control the orphanage?
Yeah.
For like 2 weeks.
2 weeks?
Yeah.
Okay.
So, are you religious like me?
Yes, everyone. So yeah, how long would you think it would take?
For me, I think for around 3 years.
3 years?
Yeah.
Two, 3 months?
I'd say about
1 month.
1 month? Yeah. It's around hours to days. I don't think it'll take that long to be honest.
It took me 7 years to do it.
Really?
Yep.
Meet Miss Lu and Miss Sam. They may be teachers at SWA, but they also have experience in adopting children from orphanages. Let's see what they have to say.
So, how long has it been since you adopted your child?
I officially adopted my daughter around about 2 years ago.
Just over 2 years.
2 years?
2 years ago I adopted them.
Oh.
How was the process of adopting a child?
For Indonesia, you need to have been married for 5 years. Mm-hmm. Before you're allowed to adopt. You need to prove that you cannot have a child. So you need to go to a fertility clinic and have checks done.
I started when I was living in Vietnam, and I tried to adopt Vietnamese children, and then I went through a whole process of trying to adopt from all over the world. Then I went to live in Spain and tried the process again, and then after 4 years in Spain, I went to live in Kuwait, and then I tried it again, and I managed to adopt them from Ethiopia.
I see.
After 7 years.
You need to do a psychological test and pass the psychological test, and that was about 2 or 3 hours of testing, 300 questions.
The problem is you can't take them out of the orphanage to live with you.
Okay. Do you think the government is doing enough for this problem?
We see little kids running around.
They can't really do that. They're lying.
Yeah.
Because they try to help this place, they can't help this place at the same time. They can't be at two places at once, even though they're people. So yeah, but they should help.
Yeah.
Some kind of background checks on people and realize that we need to simplify certain processes.
The government and that particular country in Angola was not doing enough. It had a lot of wealth from its natural resources, but that wealth was not being used to benefit the people of that country.
You mean that the government needs to make the process of adopting a child easier?
Let's go kid shopping.
Okay.
You didn't let us interview him.
Really?
He's so mean. He's just sitting around doing nothing. Like, every interview, he's like, I cannot speak English.
What?